This is Victor Felbrick here, and today I'll be showcasing Magnalab's wireless SCT200W series. What I've got set up here, this is the wireless unit, and I have it hooked up to a Measure Logic DTS310. This particular one is a Modbus TCP model. And as you can see, there's no CTs hooked up other than just this wire going over here. I've got it hooked up into a regular wall receptacle down here, and so that's 120 volt, and what I've done is I've taken my CTs over into this particular machine, and what this doing is, this is just a signal generator. We're creating, let's see, where is that, 100 amps at 60 hertz. So 100 amps at 60 hertz. Because it's a signal generator, we expect to see the power factor off because it's getting the voltage from the wall. But looking here, I've got my three CTs. And what this is doing, this is passing 100 amps through this through the primary. You can see these Magnalab units. This is an 800 amp, so 333 millivolt. And what we've done is right now for this setup, I've just got a crossover cable hooking up to the DTS310. And what you'll see on the screen is, sure enough, the current that it's picking up right here is 100 amps, getting 121 volts from the DTS310, and you'll notice the B and C phases are reading zeros, and that's simply because I don't have a three-phase setup in this particular scenario. As I indicated, the power factor is horrible, and you'd expect to see that just because these waveforms are totally, they're not in line at all with one another. And just to finish this setup, I'll just show you how this was configured. Here on the current, I specified 800 amps on the primary and 1 on the secondary, which is how you do that on a Measure Logic unit when you're using 333 millivolt CTs. The last thing I'll show here simply is the CT. Notice how it's completely wireless, there's no wires on there, and that's the guy that's communicating back to this base. That base is hooked up with the wires, like I mentioned, to the DTS310, and that's how it's getting its signal. Thank you.